हेलो व्यूअर्स, हमने हमारे पिछले लेक्चर नंबर 5 में डेटा कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम, डेटा एंड सिग्नल्स, मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन एंड ट्रांसमिशन मीडिया के बारे में पढ़ा। वी ऑल्सो लर्नड दैट द नेटवर्क्स वर्क ऑन अ लेयर्ड कंसेप्ट। इन टुडेज क्लास वील स्टडी टू सच लेयर्ड मॉडल्स, द ओएसआई मॉडल एंड द टीसीपीआईपी मॉडल। मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स का क्या है? टू ट्रांसफर डेटा फ्रॉम द सेंडर टू द रिसीवर। दिस टास्क कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू सब टास्क एंड ईच इज डन बाय डिफरेंट लेयर्स। वील स्टडी अबाउट दीज नेटवर्किंग लेयर्स टुडे। बट बिफोर वी अंडरस्टैंड दीज लेयर्स, लेट अस फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड द टास्क इन्वॉल्व्ड इन अ ट्रेडिशनल कम्युनिकेशन। जैसे कि आप अगर लेटर लिख रहे हैं अपने फ्रेंड को, देन वॉट विल बी द टास्क इन्वॉल्व्ड? से देयर इज अ सेंडर, द पर्सन हु राइट्स अ लेटर, एंड ही वॉन्ट्स टू राइट अ लेटर टू दिस पर्सन हु बिकम्स द रिसीवर। द इंडिविजुअल हु इज राइटिंग द लेटर फर्स्ट राइट्स अ लेटर, पुट्स इट इन एन एनवलप एंड ड्रॉप्स इट इन अ मेल बॉक्स। In the second subtask, the letter is carried from the mailbox to the post office, and then the letter is delivered to a carrier by the post office. The letter then travels to the destination, and what are the processes which take place at the destination? The letter is delivered from the carrier to the post office. The letter is carried from the post office to the individual's mailbox for whom the letter is meant, and then the letter is picked up, removed from the envelope and read by the receiver. Similarly, the networking layers which we are talking about, they have the lower layers which does these tasks, that is the delivery of the letter or the message or the data to the correct destination. And then we have the middle layers which are responsible for, in a way, correct transportation to the correct individual. And then we have the higher layers which are responsible for the presentation of the data to the individual in a format which is required, so that he can understand, he can read it, or if he is a sender, he can write it appropriately. This is the OSI model. OSI stands for Open Systems Interconnection. This model was developed by International Organization for Standardization, ISO, and it defines the networking framework to implement the protocols in the layers. This model allows different platforms to communicate. Platform ka kya matlab hai? It means the different devices, the different varieties of hardwares we have, the various brands of softwares, the operating systems, etc. Otherwise, we know that there will be compatibility issues and the communication would not take place. हमने जैसा पिछले हमारे डायग्राम में देखा, आप देख सकते हैं, सिमिलर टू अ ट्रेडिशनल मेथड ऑफ राइटिंग अ लेटर, इन द ओएसआई मॉडल वी हैव द लेयर्स विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द अपर लेयर ऑफ द वर्क, एज वी हैव सीन इन द प्रीवियस डायग्राम। देन देयर इज अ लेयर विच इज द हार्ट ऑफ द ओएसआई, इट इज द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर, एंड वी हैव द लोअर लेयर्स। दिस मॉडल defines the protocols, that is the set of rules for network communication. Each of these layers, the physical layer, the data link layer, network, transport, session, presentation and application, have got their specific task, and each layer cooperates with the layers above and below, and they transfer data to them. Either they take the data as input and give it to the next layer as the output, or vice versa. Now let us see the task of each of these layer. At the application layer, the application layer supplies the network services to the end user application such that the communication at the application program on which a user is working in a network is possible. Then coming to the presentation layer, it works as the translator for the network and converts the application data to a sending format at the sending point. And from the sending format to the application data format at the receiving station. Then coming to the session layer, the session layer allows two application processes on different machines to establish, use, and terminate a connection. The transport layer, it ensures the data delivery is error-free, it is in a sequence and without any loss or duplication. The network layer. Network layer provides routing paths for the network communication. The data is transferred via the logical network paths. The data link layer. The data link layer is concerned with the managing of the traffic over the physical medium of transmission and for moving the data packets from the NIC, that is the network interface card of the devices, to the transmission channel. The last layer, the physical layer, it is the layer one. The physical layer is responsible for the transmission of raw bits of data over the physical medium such as the cables. At the sender, we can say that the data is moving from the top layer, the seventh number layer, to the first, and at the receiver station, the data moves from the bottom to top. During transmission, the data passes through the intermediate devices such as the routers and the switches. At these devices, only the first three layers are involved. The physical layer provides interface for the physical transfer of the data. These are the cables. जो हमारा sending unit है, हमारा जो sending device है, वहां पर जब आपका data travel होता है, तब वो layer 7 से layer 1 की तरफ move होता है, and then it passes through the in between switches and routers, जहां पर उसका processing layer 3 तक होता है, and then finally at the receiver station, it moves from the physical layer, that is layer 1, to the layer 7. Now the remaining processing of the data will take place at the receiver terminal and the person can open up the application or the mails or whatever. The TCP/IP model is similar to the OSI model with certain functionalities merged. You can see that the physical layer and the data link layer are merged together to form the network interface layer, and the session, presentation and application are merged together to form the application layer. There are various protocols which function at each layer. This chart shows the TCP/IP protocols. At network layer, you can see that the IP, that is called the inter-network protocol, functions, which is responsible for the source to destination transmission of data at the correct address. It is possible because of the address of each device. There is physical address and there is logical address. The physical address is the lowest level of address, also known as the link address. This is local to the network. The MAC is a type of physical address. MAC stands for Media Access Control Address. ये एक 6 byte, that is 48 bit address है. And MAC is imprinted on the network interface card. आपके जो NIC card हैं devices के, उनके ऊपर ये MAC address है, ये imprinted होता है. And it is company built. During communication, we have already seen in our previous lecture that the switches keep a record of the MAC address of the device in their network. The logical addresses are used for the universal communication. The logical address is also called the IP address or the Internet Protocol address. Currently, there are two versions of IP address, IPv4, which is a 32-bit address, and it is capable of supporting 2 raised to 32 nodes. Because of the shortage of the addresses, we are migrating to IPv6. IPv6 has 128-bit. It is capable of supporting 2 raised to 128 nodes. The routers use IP address for their routing. The logical address and the physical address, they facilitate transmission of data to the desired destination. But there may be a variety of applications or processes on which the source, that is the sender, and the destination, that is the receiver, may be using at any point of time. जैसे अगर मैं हूँ, मैं अपने destination पर, I may be exchanging mails, I may be chatting with somebody, I may be doing the web surfing, etc. Practically, we use more than one application at a time. And for correct transmission of data to the process, there is an address given to the process or the application. It is this address which identifies the process, and it is called the port address. Port address is a 16-bit address. Example ke taur pe jo aapka HTTP hai, it uses the port address 18. Under HTTP, the different windows of a web browser are identified using specific address called the URL. What is URL? It is Uniform Resource Locator. And it is used for identifying the websites. Like if we are using email, then we have the email addresses. I am sure networking and communication class ke baad, aapke man mein security on networks ko lekar kai sawal umad rahe honge. Security on computers and networks ki hum alag se class lenge. Usme hum malware, viruses, firewalls, security precautions, encryptions, इन सबको जानेंगे. Internet functioning को काफी हद तक हमने आज के topic में समझ लिया है, लेकिन कुछ important terms हैं with respect to internet, इसे हम हमारी अगली class में देखेंगे. Thank you so much and see you in the next class.